Class 10, we have started yesterday Coorg. Okay, so tell me about its location, where it is situated. Where it is situated? It's situated in the coastal town of Mysore as well as between Odisha. Okay, and ultimately what it is famous for? It is famous for evergreen rainforest and spices and coffee plantation. So what kind of scene was created by the author in this chapter? By the writer, what kind of areas are prevalent? That under the canopies of trees, what it stood? Cluster of bungalows they stood. Okay, and everywhere there is smell of coffee. Okay, so what is one quality of the Coorgian people? Yes, they are perfect in martial arts and they are associated with the tales of bravery. Okay, they are very much associated with the tales of bravery. So which is the favorable season to go there? September till March. Why this is the favorable season to go there? Why it is perfect? Because of less rainfall, otherwise throughout the year, there is plenty of rainfall in the area, which keep away the visitors to come there, right? Now, for their descent, what are the various tales prevalent from where they have descended? From Greeks and Arabs. Okay, what are the tales? Now tell me. Okay, Alexander, what Alexander? What? Nee, what legend is associated with Alexander? Okay. Because of their inability to return back. They settled there, then they married the local women. And their culture, it has been seen that their culture has a blend of what? It has blend of the culture of you can say Greeks as well as that of the local people, but it is different from the Hindu mainstream. And what is the other example given? That of Arabs. How their association is related to that of Arabs? Yes, because they are wearing a long robe, which is called as long. Okay, long dress coat or long robe, same. So, which is called as kupia. Okay, and the belt, the belt that is an embroidered belt that they are wearing around their waist is called as kufi. It is kufia, right? Okay, it's known as kufia. Okay, so this is the reason why they are attached. And moreover, what is the great privilege enjoyed by the Coorgian people? That they can carry firearms without license. And it is just because of this reason that the Coorgian regiment is one of the most embellished one, right? So the first first chief of the Indian army, whose name was Kariappa, he was also from Coorg. So next, let us start further. The river Kaveri obtains its water from the hills and forests of Coorg. So from where does this Kaveri river get its water? From hills and forests of Coorg. Okay. Mahaseer, a large freshwater fish. Underline it. What is the name of the large freshwater fish? It is Mahaseer. Abound in these waters. So which fish lives in the waters of this river? It is Mahaseer. And kingfishers dive for their catch, while squirrels and langurs drop partially eaten fruit for the mischief of enjoying the splash and the ripple effect. Ripple effect means wavy effect. Ripple effect of the clear water. So what are the different animals which are found there? Kingfishers, squirrels, Langurs, okay, elephants enjoy being bathed and scrubbed in the river by their mahouts. What is a mahout? Person responsible for taming the elephant and giving instructions to the elephant is called as mahout. Okay, so it means that here in this paragraph, the main river which flows through it is Kaveri River. And from where does it get its water? From the hills of, from the hills, okay, which is which are present in the forest in Kudh. And which main freshwater fish is found there? Mahaseer. Very good. Mahaseer freshwater fish is found there. The most laid back individuals become converts to the life of high energy adventure and river rafting. So now here the nature of the people of Kudh, that they are mostly quite adventurous in nature, right? They play different kind of adventurous sports. So let us see which sports are being played there. Rafting, canoeing. Rafting, you know, and canoeing means canoe is a narrow boat. Okay, mainly you must have seen which is used during the races. Okay, canoe race. Rappelling. This is also water sport, rock climbing and mountain hiking, and numerous walking trails in this region are a famous are a favorite with trekkers. And numerous walking trails means like the trek, people like to trek in these areas because of the presence of hills. So here in this chapter, different kind of animals which are found in Kudh are also given, and moreover different type of sports being played by the people is also explained here. So let us speak, what are the different kind of sports played there? River rafting, canoeing, mountaineering, trekking, rappelling, mountain climbing or mountain biking. So next, birds, bees and butterflies are there to give you company. So these are the other insects found there. Birds and insects. Okay, macaws, Malabar squirrels, langurs, slender lots keep a watchful eye from the tree canopy. Means these are the animals which can be found on the trees. So speak out the names. Okay, langurs, macaws, Malabar squirrels are also found there. The climb in the Brahmagiri Hills brings you into a panoramic view of the entire misty landscape of Kudh. Okay, panoramic means having a wide view of the beautiful landscape of Kudh. This where you will get when you will reach to the Brahmagiri Hills. You please keep quiet. Okay, when you reach to the Brahmagiri Hills, you will get complete panoramic view of the beauty of the landscape, which is engulfed or which is, you can say, present in Kudh. A walk across the rope bridge leads to the 64-acre island of Nisargadham. Okay, so when you walk over the rope bridge, there is a famous rope bridge also. When you walk over it, you will reach an island. What was the name of the island? Nisargadham. Running into Buddhist monks from India's largest Tibetan settlement at nearby Bailakup is a bonus. It means that this is a quite kind of very calm place where Buddhist monks can be seen, which are monks followers of Buddha. Okay, right, these monks could be seen, and this will definitely be you can say a benefit for you. And where they are living in one of the largest Tibetan settlement, means there are most of the Tibetan people settled there, where they are settled near Bailakup. And the monks in red austere and yellow robes. Austere means the long coat they are wearing. Okay, and yellow robe are among us. The many surprises that wait to be discovered by the visitors searching for the heart and soul of India. And this is the place when person loves to watch the beauty of India, the heart and soul of India, there one can find. I mean, this is the actuality of India, what actually India is. And one is right here in Kudh. Clear now this chapter? Yes. Right? Means it is actually a factual one. Factual description is given here. with number of facts to be remembered. Okay, mainly this question is asked if it is in subjective about their descent. So who will read this? How to reach their fact file? Yes. Yes, Raghav, stand up. Or Anshika, stand up. Read this fact file. How to reach? Yes, from this place one can go to Kurk. This is actually for your knowledge only. Yes. See how the beauty is explained. Will cast a spell. I mean, you will feel that we are not on land. We are actually living in heaven. This will have a great effect, magical effect upon you. Yes, not to try to live in a hotel, but some coffee estate or in a Kurgian home. This will give you really real Kurgi experience. Right, Chennai, Delhi, Goa, Hyderabad, Kochi, Kolkata, Mumbai and Pune. It means that you will take different kind of flights to reach there also. By road. Sorry, by rail. And Hassan. Okay. Neela Mangalam. It is Chandrayan, Patna. Okay. So that's all. These are the different routes given to you, whichever you want to opt. So whenever you will get time, try to visit there. Okay, to refresh your senses whenever you will be free. Yes. Pehle paper nahi. First of all, you need to settle at a proper place. Okay. Okay, that will also be the right time. Because there you will find monks and ultimately you will find spiritual attainment. This will also be the right time. No, this is not the joke. So, have you ever thought what you will do at that time in 50s? Thought? Have you ever thought what you will do in 50s? No, this time your mind is occupied with your future only. That we need to settle at a proper job. We need to settle in life, right? This you will think afterwards when you get mature at the age of 35 to 40. Then you will start thinking. It's a phase by phase development of human mind. Okay? So next, coming up to the question answers, let us see. Where is Kurk situated? Mysore is situated between Mysore and coastal town of Mangalore, and it is just like a piece of heaven which has been descended or which has been drifted from the kingdom of God. One can feel spellbound or one can have a magical effect to see when one reaches Kurk. Next, what is the story about the Kodavu people's descent? Again, I told you two stories are prevalent, one with Greek as well as the other with Arab descent. According to Greek descent, that it has been believed that some of the men of the Alexander's army, while they came and settled there, they were unable to return back, or they were, because of their inability to go back, so the army moved south along the coast and settled there. They married the local women, so this is the reason why their culture is showing a blend, or it is also showing a glimpse of the local culture along with their own culture, but it is quite different from the Hindu mainstream. The other one is that of Arab descent, because the kind of black coat they wear, okay, and the embroidered waist belt worn by them, okay, but it is known as kufia, and it resembles to that of kufia which is worn by Arabs, because of the similarity in their dresses. So this is the reason why it seems to be that they have their similar origin or similar descent. Next question is, what are some of the things you know, you now know about the people of Coorg? Yes, tell me. What do you know about people of Coorg? Yes, who will tell me? Vineet Roop? Yes. What do you know about the people of Coorg? Sit down, please. Next, you were absent. Next, Daksh. What do you know about the people of Coorg? It's very bad. They are? I'm not getting. Okay, they have their Greek and Arabic descent, right? Then they are endowed with martial arts, with the skill of martial arts. Then they was black. That is related to their descent. Other things, brave. Okay, proud men of martial men. And okay, then afterwards, other examples. Okay, they have the privilege to carry firearms without any. Sit down, please. Sit down. Without any license, right? Okay. Many tales of bravery and valor are associated with their generations. And it is because of this reason that the Coorgian army or the Coorgian regiment is one of the most embellished one. The first chief of the Indian army was also a Coorgian and his name was Kariappa. Okay. So these people, they have a blend of culture of the local Hindu people as well as that of their own culture, but it is quite different from the actual Hindu mainstream, right? So next is the main crop of Coorg. What is this? Coffee. Okay, coffee is the main plantation grown there, or coffee is the main plant grown there. It can be widespread estates of coffee could be seen. Okay, covered tucked under, you can say, coffee plantations with bungalows tucked under the canopies of trees. Next, the sports in it offers to tourists. What are the different sports? Okay, rafting, canoeing, water rappelling, rock climbing, mountain biking, okay, and trekking. Trekking also, right? Next is the animals you are likely to see in Coorg. Which are the different animals you are likely? Okay, macaws, langurs, squirrels, elephants, mahaseer, fish could be seen in the Kaveri River, white squirrels, elephants we have done, birds, in case butterflies, bees, they could be seen there. Next, its distance from Bangalore and how to get there. It has been asked from this fact file. But they have asked fact file. So just have a look over it. How to get there by? Okay, it is? How much it is? 260 kilometer, 250 to 260 kilometer, and the main route via Mysore is the frequent one, and the other route is through Neelmangal. Okay, just remember it. Next one is, here are six sentences with some words in italics. Find phrases from the text that have the same meaning. Now, during monsoon it rains so heavily, the tourists do not visit Coorg. So yes, what is the phrase used here? Keep the tourists away. This is the phrase we have read here. To keep the tourists away. See the paragraph, second one. Next, the Coorg people are always ready to tell stories of their sons and forefathers' valor. What is the phrase used there? Tales, what tales phrase? Huh? Recount numerous tales. Right? Now you got? I think you have found also. Okay, fine. Next is, even people who normally led an easy and slow life get smitten by the high energy adventure sports. Yes. The most laid back individuals. Very good. The most laid back individuals. Next. The theory of the herb origin is supported by the long coat with embroidered waist belt they wear. Yes. Very good. Draws support. Good. Next is macaws, malabar squirrels. Observe you. Have a keep a watchful eye. Very good. So it means that you have read it very carefully. Okay. Now next, we will start studying about Assam. Okay. Tomorrow we will start for the description of Assam. And after that, this chapter will be completed.